haven't exactly been keeping it a secret. We raided security on the Hope after Wells broke in. Esker discovered the identity of the missing colonist. All we had to do was get him to the manifest. You have something I want. I'd like to negotiate. Yes, I'm aware that you stole a batch of precious chemicals and destroyed an important experiment. Enterprising of you, if irritating. My scientists tell me they'll restore the damage you've done in a matter of months. But I'm not here to talk about minor setbacks. Phineas Wells is wanted by the board. I want to convince you to turn him in to us.
Ich kenne ihn nicht.
Wells is a dangerous madman. His plan is going to endanger everyone in Halcyon. He's an obsessive psychopath. And he's using you. You're in contact with Wells. I want you to send us a tracing signal from a don't worry about pay. The board always rewards good work. Wells was our mistake. We failed to apprehend him for years. I'm asking you to help me correct that mistake. I'm sending you my access code. Contact me from Wells' terminal. When you're done, come speak to me in my office.
Adjutant Acorda's call has been terminated.
Je pensais que ça allait enlever ma... mon kit négatif. I was one. Science.
Crazy, even to me.
Your instincts are correct. By any reasonable definition of sanity, this plan is crazy. Isn't it wonderful? You'll need to switch on the host auxiliary power using the unreliable. Then head to the bridge. Your navigational computer, Ada, should be able to activate the home skip drive. Once you skip the home next to my lab, I'll have easy access to the frozen colonists. I can start reviving them. Use the code.
You'll be fine.
I could probably spend years fixing this boat. Stand this game.
Captain, you have a message from Adjutant Sophia.
I'm impressed, Captain. I almost expected you wouldn't go through with it. Unfortunately, Dr. Wells found a way to corrupt the signal before we could pinpoint his location. Still, it's only a matter of time before we find him. Come visit me in Byzantium. We need to have a talk about the future of this colony. Meet me in my office. I've authorized your ship at my personal landing pad.
Adjutant Cardin has ended her call. Rather rudely, if I might say, considering she didn't sign off. Will there be anything else, Captain?
Draußen.
Sending a corrupted tracking signal to the board was quite clever, if I might say, Captain. Welcome back, Captain. How can I be of assistance? What part of the colony? Where am I? The armpit of the Halcyons.
The armpit?
I believe it has something to do with the planet being an you may wish to survey the rest. It's something like may look. We have arrived at the Hope. I need you to reroute power from our ship to the Hope's auxiliary generator. You'll have to connect me to the Hope's power system so I can convince your central computer to enable the slip drive. If your populations are even slightly off, you could crash the entire colony ship into Terra too. Or the sun. Forgetfulness can be an early warning sign of asphyxiation due to loss of pressurization. I need you to reroute power from your connecting to the Hope. The Hope is the groundbreaker's prettier, sleeper sister. She wandered off and got lost. Also, there are hundreds of thousands of frozen organic life forms hibernating in her hold.
Prettier, the precursor, prettier sister, bigger and prettier sister. Ce qui me donne le stealth.
Not exploding, so I guess it worked.
You see the latest visit, Hunter? I can't believe it.
Can't think of much worse than drooling on your pillow in front of a bunch of strangers.
Gonna do this? I've seen lots of crazy, Captain, but Phineas is in the class of his own. Do you really think he knows what he's doing? Sending us to skip the Hope into Territory's orbit right under the board's nose? Something tells me you're the first person to ever utter those words, Captain. I think this whole plan is insane, but it'll make a good story, you know, if we survive. Speaking of, I get that Phineas thinks he's saving the colony. What about you? Why risk your neck on this crazy scheme? I'm gonna try to forget that you've been calling the shots this whole time. Still,
yes.
You know, they're gonna make a serial about our. I've been trying to think of. No, wait, I got it. Hope in dark times. Get it? Hope? Like. Yeah, I've been thinking about it.
Thrilling tales of the unreliable.
Or maybe.
Chilling stories from the edge of a system.
Was also impartial to that last. Not bad. Got a nice ring to it.
Stealing the Hope from the board, skipping it across the whole deck.
Enough to boost my pay? I'm sure you've got plans to make.
Should we assign 7 for our cleanup?
Something up on one horse here. It was a 12. Oh, yeah. Slaughter Island.
Oh, son of a bitch. fous de mon cul. C'est pas un putain de garde-manger.
private quarters at the Hope's fallen crew. Shall we hold a moment of silence for the dearly departed?
No.
That's odd, because my partner is thinking that we're forced to confront the idea of self-death. Organics prefer... Yes, never mind.
On n'est pas des cannibales. What? Deco. Ça fait penser au film. Pas très bon film là.
And also potentially kill an entire planet.
Meh. Banzai! Nice. C'est la fin du jeu. Allez, hop, dans le soleil.
all good. We are still alive and have successfully escaped into trip.
Thank you.
No. No. Lobo. Get up. Bye bye. Que tu vas aller dehors dans la neige? Que la neige. Neige. Quoi, ça c'est 25, ça c'est 11, ça c'est quoi? Oups. Ça
Thank the Lord you warned me. I was able to get some defenses up, but they might not be enough. The board has sent some serious firepower to pry me out of here. They're trying to get in, and I'm not sure I can stop them. If they capture me, if we can't communicate again, there's something very important you need to remember. The board, all their lackeys, they're all a bunch of swine. Do you hear me? They're fucking corporate swine. You fucking pigs!
It would seem that recording comes from some rather dire events. I presume you'll want to dock at the orbital lab to check on your associate as soon as possible. How can I be of assistance? Goodbye.
Avant, je vais aller vendre mes shit. J'ai trop de shit.
Earth's ordinance 8885. Human, you are in violation of cleanliness ordinance 8886. Human, you are in violation of cleanliness ordinance 8887.
Boss, coming to alarm you, but I'm going to do violations of the cleanliness ordinance.
If you're here for... I've got a lot.
Chiama meno. Secret orbital lab. Thank you. Oh shit. J'ai pas remarqué qu'il y avait du monde ici. des mines. Force de Finn. Mama fire.
I
Biotic secret lab.
Thank you.
Marilyn Fenhill. Walls. Whoa, 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 whoa. Pause est fini. Get back to work. Ouch.
Maximum security prison on an uninhabitable planet. Being incarcerated there is seen as a fate worse than death.
Still, we can't do nothing. It wouldn't be right.
The armed surveillance programs on a maximum security prison planet are highly sophisticated.
Mm.
At least it'll be a great story.
Got my trusty tossball stick, got my ass kicking boots. I'm ready, boss.
Outstanding.
You can count on us, Captain. We're crew. For real crew. That means we've got each other's backs. Right.
Never thought I'd volunteer to break into a prison. Seems like your tendency towards risky behavior is rubbing off on me, Captain.
Command, not recognized.
Such a nice crew. C'est le meilleur des mondes.
we might want to consider changing our clothes more often.
Definitely quest. Ça part en steak tartare.
May luck be with you.
Thank you.
Oh! 10 000 pour ça. Une vache ou pas.
a bonus. And I see you brought the kid along. Babysitters may be expensive, but they're worth it, you know.
Yeah, yeah, keep talking, pal. I'll just keep thinking of a place to bury your body.
And the convict. The vicar. You know, most people, once they're out of prison, don't seem keen on returning. Oh, I would go anywhere to see you, uniform, sir.
When you go off and get yourself shot, try to avoid taking one to the face. I want it better than easy to shoot to my citizens.
Haven't you heard? Phineas is working for us now. It took some doing, but employing an efficient management strategy of putting our guns to his head seems to have done the trick.
Pourquoi je sais pas juste lui tirer une balle dans la tête exactement? Ça au chocolat blanc. J'espère que j'ai tué le président. En ce moment, je t'ai combien juste pour savoir? 67%.
talent for complicating my life. You've been working with Dr. Wells from the beginning. When we moved to arrest him, he was prepared. I lost good soldiers in the attempt. You've disrupted the balance of power. You've upset the natural order of things. You've introduced uncertainty, and there is nothing I despise more than uncertainty. Typical. Running your mouth in the middle of a crisis. It's almost as if you delight in chaos. I should have dealt with you a long time ago. You were always too dangerous to leave unchecked. Leaving you alive is my greatest mistake, but it is a mistake I intend to correct. I have Dr. Wells in my custody. Once I've secured his cooperation, I can move forward with the program. I can repair the damage he done. I can set things right.
Yes.
I take no pleasure in this. I simply have no other option. Leaving you alive is too great a risk. Goodbye, Captain. I had a feeling you'd say that. This prison is equipped with an auto-mechanical warden. I've had it and don't worry. I will inform Dr.
It's him, the last boss.
You don't know how glad I am to see you.
You did the right thing.
Akane was a monster. Her death was much deserved.
And long overdue.
And you, you lunatic, you broke into the Borg's own fortress just to rescue one doddering old man.
You are absolutely out of your mind. And I can't begin to thank you enough.
Yes.
You've broken the old stranglehold on this colony, and you saved my life. There's still so much we have yet to accomplish. You and I are going to have to work harder than ever to save House. I'm afraid the situation is far worse than any of us ever anticipated. Theatrics. Merciful law, I wish I were exaggerating. Earth has gone dark. We haven't received a single message in 3 years. There's been no communication, no signals, nothing. 2 years ago, the Earth's Directorate's frigate disappeared on their way back to Earth. I don't know what they discovered when they arrived, or if they arrived at all. Hold on, Doc. You tell me the Earth went dark 3 years ago, and the board's just been covering this up. They've been incredibly effective at concealing the truth. Right now, the only people in the colony who know are standing in this room. Earth is only an idea to us, but that idea is the bedrock the colony is built upon. If people were to find out it's gone dark, the shock could be too much to bear. I don't want to imagine what will happen once news gets out. Let's just keep this between us for now. We're in serious trouble. Do you know what this means for Halcyon? We can't rely on Earth to support any war. We've been cut loose. We're entirely lost. Yes, yes, certainly. You might have heard of the Earth Directorate's frigate. Half the colony's entire military was on that ship. They were returned to Earth when they vanished without a trace. That was 2 years ago. We haven't heard a word from them since. Whatever. Yes, Akande mentioned as much. Akande had kept the truth to herself. Perhaps. I wasn't trying to hide the truth from you. But after all you've done... Yes, I experimented on the Hope's colonists. Each of my experiments ended in a catastrophic failure. Each of my subjects died in agony. You are my first and only success. I didn't tell you about the others because... I'm not asking you to forgive me. My apologies. If you have... I don't know what happened. We have no connection. I heard it from a... She... Yes. A cop. Yes, you were the one who reactivated that relay station, weren't you? Any message from Earth would have arrived unencrypted. It's been 3 years since our last message. The Borg tried using drones to contact Earth. Every one of those drones sent back the same encrypted message. Earth is completely silent. Yes, we must. We're going to need a leader. And I can't imagine a better person for the job than you. What do you say, old friend? Will you help us? When I revived you, I had our roles reversed, you see. You're the one who's going to say, you're the best thing to ever happen to Halcyon. We're not a colony any longer, are we? Our future is uncertain.
Okay, man.
The OSI teaches that everything in the universe happens according to the grand plan. But the stranger that arrived in Halcyon was an unplanned variable. From the moment he landed in Emerald Vale, his actions altered the course of history. The events on Tartarus brought about the end of the Board's authority. But the Board's mistakes would haunt the colony for decades to come. The damage they left behind would require the work of a generation to repair. Dr. Phineas Wells began reviving a handful of the host colonies. Engineers, scientists, technicians, and intellectuals. They were among the brightest minds the Earth had ever sent out into the sun. The Hope scientists and engineers woke up in a colony descending headlong into total collapse. With no way to return to Earth, they had no choice but to band together and devote themselves to the cause of saving Halcyon. The people of Halcyon were nothing if not hardy. In the absence of the Board's authority, many of the colony settlements banded together with a single purpose in mind, survival. Life was especially hard in the years to come. Some towns dissolved by attrition and starvation, but most of them found a way to carry on. In the years to come, Halcyon was forced to reckon with its newfound freedom. The Board was gone, and for better or worse, the colony was responsible for its own destiny. Sanjar's civil liberties and worker-centered policies were slow to catch on with the other corporations. But as Halcyon began its long, arduous journey toward recovery, many of Terra 2's smaller townships started adopting MSI's alternative corporate structure, and eventually became entirely In the coming years, many of these townships managed to eke by, where otherwise they might have starved. Consumed by a paranoia, Lilia Hagen took sublight salvage in a controversial direction, openly accusing Board officials of an extraterrestrial conspiracy. One day, an accident at the Groundbreaker's docking bay silenced her forever. Time would tell if her replacement could keep the sublight family together. The collapse of Edgewater left its workers bereft of any purpose in life. Most of them made their way to Adelaide McDevitt's camp, hoping to ingratiate themselves into her favor. Adelaide accepted only a few of the community. The rest were turned away, and likely died of starvation. Nevertheless, Adelaide's camp grew into a well-established town. Adelaide McDevitt refused to cooperate with the ongoing effort to save Halcyon from collapse. A sympathetic reservist stole a copy of her research and delivered it to the Hope's scientists. It is unclear how useful Adelaide's research was. An optimistic estimate suggests her work may have bought Halcyon another few years of survival. Adelaide would never know. She died that winter. Under the leadership of Julie Tennyson, the Groundbreaker held firm against corporate influence. The ship's mechanical stability gave Julie the time to educate a promising generation of engineers, schooled in her family's tradition. The future of the Groundbreaker looks promising. The rediscovery of the Hope and the abandonment of the lifetime employment program forced Byzantium to come to terms with some uncomfortable realities about the state of Halcyon. While Byzantines were reluctant to surrender the luxuries they'd grown accustomed to, The board's diminished authority gave them little choice in the matter. Nearly everyone had to learn to make do with less. Some even had to get jobs. It was a dark time. Your influence further cemented everything. She understood she could never truly rely on others, so she set about making sure she wouldn't have to. With a steady income from the life insurance payouts, she was finally able to afford a ship of her own. She enjoyed a long and infamous career running the business. Some of them were even legal. Life in Halcyon was so rich for Felix Minstone. The grand revolution he dreamed of never came. There was no great awakening for the colony, no celebrations in the streets. There was only the hard, desperate work of trying to repair a broken colony. Felix never had a head for numbers, but if there was labor to be done, he was there to help. Eventually, Felix realized that the work of a revolution was done with two hands. As much as he enjoyed his adventures aboard the Unreliable, the vicar, known as Max, eventually decided that it was time to move on, to live out the life he had sought so long to feel. He knew there were many in the colony who carried burdens much worse than the ones he had struggled with, and he devoted himself to easing their suffering wherever he could. He only ever took up arms again to defend the defenseless. Unshackled from a lifetime of striving and fighting the universe and himself, Vicar Maximilian de Soto was finally at peace. Though Parvati eventually grew comfortable aboard the Unreliable, she never quite came out of her shell. She seemed to prefer the company of Ada to the crew, and she could often be found neck deep in cables and grease, telling Ada funny stories from her childhood. While the colony fell into chaos, she found an island of relative peace with Ada, and they formed an unusual bond. She decided to remain aboard the Unreliable permanently, as its chief and sole engineer. Neoka returned to Monarch to take another crack at making a permanent life for herself. She formed the Charon Group, an MSI subsidiary of ragtag survivalists and wilderness experts. Anyone in need of a guide, or just looking to throw back a beer and swap stories, could find her camping on the trail, or clearing an infestation. The sand unit that accompanied you spread awareness of the pipeline's superior sanitation and maintenance capabilities across what was left of the colony. This led to a boost in sand unit sales. Did you know that sand units are the longest lasting, toughest acting cleaning solution in Halcyon? Minister Clark was released from house arrest, and his contact with you gave him a sense of renewed purpose and vigor. Once it became clear that no help would be coming from Earth, he threw his considerable efforts and talents into helping Halcyon manage the crisis before it. As for Dr. Phineas Wells, he spent his remaining years in his orbital lab. He eventually came to terms with his own past, and was able to forgive the mistakes of his younger self by devoting his remaining years to serving the colony. Dr. Wells was able to revive many more scientists and engineers than he first expected, thanks to the additional batch of chemicals you stole from the Ministry. Wells never forgot about the human lives that were lost in acquiring these chemicals. In the end, Dr. Wells was able to save every scientist and engineer aboard the Hope. Over the next decade, nearly all of the Hope's remaining colonists were successfully revived. Halcyon saw a period of rapid technological and scientific advancement. Breakthroughs in dietary supplements saved the colony from starvation. Geoengineering projects and social reforms began to change the structure and character of the colony. Dr. Wells laid the groundwork for the project to save the colony, but he would never live to see the fruits of his labor. He passed away a few years later. His work was carried on by the scientists and engineers he revived. Today, Halcyon has stabilized. The people of the colony work hard to adapt to their new circumstances. Nearby colonies send aid and supplies. Life will never be easy in Halcyon, but for the first time in its history, there exists a sense of real, genuine hope about the future. And what about you, the unplanned variable in the history of Halcyon? Long after Wells passed away, you carried on his work with more energy, determination.
Yeah, je te scientifique.
The years that followed were hard, but Halcyon survived by the efforts of the Hope's most promising colonists, the greatest of which was you. No one knows what's happened to Earth, and no one knows what the future has in store for Halcyon. All we know for certain is this. The name of the Unreliable and that of its intrepid captain will remain the subject of countless stories for years to come.
Ok, est-ce que ça change de quoi? Oups. Mais avant tout... J'ai un connard à tuer. Fuck pas. Ah, il me donne un gun même pour le péter, kind of. Ah, je peux pas revenir sur mes pas. Arme 60, arme 70, 40. Attends, je peux-tu...
Dr. Wells is all. Fair enough. Interesting that you think I'm going to die here. I believe I'm more than capable. Fair point. I don't know how you've managed to defy the odds.
Leveling up.
Estimate you should be dead. Yet here you stand. I've devoted my entire life to protect. Not afraid to die in the line of duty. There isn't much more left, thanks to you. You've thrown this system into disarray. Cleaning up your mess will be the work of a lifetime. You were always an unknown variable. I tried to recruit you, but you threw your lot in with that madman, Phineas Wells. Yes, I'm quite aware of your brazen act of corporate vandalism. By the way, those test subjects you killed? My scientists assure me they can recover the data you destroyed. You've succeeded in temporary... It can't be. You're trying to manipulate me. That experiment was absolutely essential to the program. My scientists assured me they were close to a breakthrough. They gave me their word. Damn you. You are telling the truth. My scientists have been lying to me, and I was stupid enough to trust them at their word. Start all over again. All that research, all those experiments, you sent us back to death. I haven't given up on the program yet. I haven't lost control of the labyrinth yet. Our security system is still operational. I can still put a stop to you.
Let's still try. Nice. Yes.
The fate of the colony is in your hands now.
Je répète, j'aurais pas à péter son robot. Est-ce que ça change quoi que ce soit? Intéressant.
Dr. Wells was able to revive many more scientists and engineers than he first
In the end, Dr. Wells was able to save every scientist and engineer aboard the Hope. Over the next decade, nearly all of the Hope's remaining colonists, Dr. Wells laid the groundwork for the Today, Halcyon has stabilized. The people of the And what about you? You brought an end to the chaos on Tartarus and proved yourself the most capable leader left in the colony. You administered the colony in your own image. With the old power of the Board destroyed, a new government of Halcyon rose with you at its center.
Nice.
With your steady hand, you guided Halcyon through the turbulent years that were to follow and helped ensure the survival of the colony until the end of your days.
Nice.
No one knows what's happened to Earth, and no one knows what the future has in store for Halcyon. All we know for certain is this.
Une petite variante d'avoir laissé survivre Sophia Campbell. Mais fuck Rockwell. Peut aller chier. On va finir ça de même. On va finir ça. Bon, fini. Il faut juste repasser.